on the next topic about the heterotrophic nutrition taking place among the different varieties of living organism. Now children, what is heterotrophic nutrition? We'll come to later part. But this is a type of nutrition. What is nutrition? A mode of nutrition. Different methods of taking food is called nutrition. We have discussed in the previous video also. Now, one of the group was autotrophic, in which your plants were preparing their own food by themselves to maintain their life process. Here, today we are going to discuss about the heterotrophic nutrition, where those living organisms who cannot prepare their food by themselves. There are many animals, many non-green plants like insectivorous plants, different type of bacteria, including human beings. We cannot prepare our food by ourselves. We have to be dependent on others. We have to be dependent on plant products directly or indirectly. So there, the type of nutrition is called as heterotrophic nutrition. Now, the animals, the living organisms who are possessing this heterotrophic nutrition are called as heterotrophs. Now children, what is heterotrophic? Now it occurs in all animals, non-green plants, fungi, including man, including human beings. We all cannot prepare our food by ourselves. So what we will do? We cannot prepare our own food. So we are dependent on autotrophs directly or indirectly for food. So we cannot prepare our food. So directly or indirectly, we will be dependent on the autotrophs or the other groups of animals. Suppose I take example of a goat. Goat cannot prepare food by itself. So what does goat feeds on? The goat feeds on grasses, green leaves. So from where the goat is getting food? It is getting from the autotrophs. Now this goat will be eaten up by some higher animals like lion, tiger. They can eat fox. Now the fox cannot eat the green leaves, but they are eating the animals like goat, which is dependent on the plant product, that is leaves, grass. So directly or indirectly, we all different type of living organisms, including human beings also, we also cannot prepare our food by ourselves inside our body. Either we are vegetarian or we are non-vegetarian. We are feeding upon the green plant products, green plants directly, or we are feeding upon the animals. So we are also not preparing our food. We are dependent on others. So these type of mode of nutrition of food is called as heterotrophic nutrition. And the living organism showing heterotrophic nutrition are called as heterotrophs. So children, we are called as heterotrophs because we are having the mode of nutrition, heterotrophic nutrition, and we are dependent on others for our food. So children, when there are different type of living organisms, so obviously they will have different modes of nutrition also. So there are various and various types of heterotrophic nutrition. Now what are those types? Those types are holozoic nutrition, saprophytic nutrition, parasitic nutrition, osmotrophic nutrition, coprozoic nutrition, and mixotrophic nutrition. There are various types also, but these are the commons which we are going to discuss today in this session. Let us children now start the first type of heterotrophic nutrition, that is your holozoic nutrition. Children, this holozoic nutrition is also called as holotropic nutrition. Now, which are the organisms where your holotropic or holozoic nutrition occurs? It is your mammals, amoeba, hydra. We can take example of such type of organisms where holozoic or holotropic nutrition occurs. Now let us first understand the meaning of holozoic. Holo word is meant, which is the which means that whole, taking the whole food inside the body. And zoic word is made up from animals. Zoo. You people who visit zoo is a place where your animals are kept for our exhibition and all. So zoo word is meant for animals. So zoic word is meant for animals. So holozoic. So all those animals which take the complete food inside the body, the whole food inside the body, and process them to take energy from it. So that complete nutrition process is called holozoic nutrition or holotropic nutrition. So holozoic nutrition occurs in mammals, hydra, amoeba, and various types of other organisms. Now in this type of nutrition, the animals take food in solid form. Now we are taking food in solid form. We take rice, chapati, vegetables, pulses, they are all solid. So we take food in a solid form, and this food is taken in a definite pathway. We have mouth, oesophagus, stomach, intestine, small and large intestine, and then passing out from the anus out of the body. So we have a particular pattern, we have a particular system for the food to pass through various parts of the body and to utilize it inside the body. So all those living organisms who take the whole food in a solid form and through a particular pathway, through a particular system inside the body present, is called as holotropic or holozoic nutrition. And what are the processes now? There are various number of processes which is involved in this holozoic nutrition. Now, what are those processes? Those processes are ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation, and ejection. These are the 5-step process, children, which occurs among the animals in which holozoic nutrition occurs. First is ingestion. In, it means taking inside. Gestion means to take inside. Ingestion. So we take food inside our mouth. Taking food, taking which type of food? Taking complex type of food, like rice, chapati, solid food. When we take that solid food inside our mouth, the process is called ingestion. Now, what happens to the food, children, after taking inside the mouth? Inside the mouth, the food is chewed. That solid food is chewed. Now, after chewing, the food breaks down into small pieces. Now, those small pieces of food reaches to the stomach. Now, stomach is a place where your digestion will take place. And the next process is digestion. So, inside the stomach, the food which was chewed inside the mouth, still it is in complex form. That food is broken down into simple food components, into simple, soluble, diffusible, which the body can easily accept it. Now, in that simple form, the complex food is broken down. It means that the bigger pieces of food is chewed and it is turned into paste. So, inside the stomach of any of the living organism, now the food, complex food, is broken down. It is digested into simple food molecule. That means it is converted into paste. So, the second step was digestion. Now, children, what will happen after digestion? Inside the stomach, when the food is broken down, after that, what happens? The food is passed through the various parts of intestine, small intestine and large intestine. This is only the pathway of our alimentary canal. The food enters in the mouth, then it passes to food pipe, then it enters the stomach. From stomach, food passes into small intestine, large intestine, absorbed inside the food, and then the waste is thrown out by the anus, through the anus. So, children, here the first step was ingestion, in which we were taking complex food in our mouth. The second step was digestion, when the food was reaching inside the stomach and complex food was broken down into simple food. Now, the third step is absorption. That means that simple food, that paste converted food, will now be absorbed inside the body. It means that body will utilize that food to convert it into energy. The food will reach to the cells. So, So your absorption, the absorption by the various parts by the small intestine and large intestine, your that passing simple soluble nutrients into the blood. So your absorption takes place. So what is absorption? Absorption is that the food, simple food material from the intestine is passing into the blood so that it can be taken to the cells for its utilization. Now inside the cells, assimilation process, the next process occurs. And now inside, during this assimilation, energy is produced and it is utilized by the body in various activities, in various processes. And now children, the absorbed food reached to the cells, it is utilized, converted into energy. But what will happen to the food which was not broken or which was not digested? That food converts into solid waste. Then that waste is thrown out from the body by the ejection process through the anus. So children, the animals who are having holozoic type of nutrition have 5-step process. Always remember, holozoic, taking food by 5-step. Those organism who takes the solid food in a 5-step process, ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation and ejection. These passing through these 5 steps, the organism taking food and releasing the waste outside into the environment through the anus, this complete nutrition process is called holozoic nutrition or holotropic nutrition. And this is one of the mode of nutrition in the heterotrophic mode. Now children, the further types like saprophytic, parasitic, coprozoic, we will be discussing in the next videos. Hope this whole session is clearly understood by you all. Thank you.